Hi, I'm registered dietitian Kate Geegan, and I'm here with rock star Ellen Gustafson, who is the co-founder or founder and executive director of the 30 Project. So tell me, as a dietitian, I was listening with a lot of interest. You talked about the twin problems of obesity and malnutrition, but how they are so connected at the American dinner table. What do you think most people in America would be shocked to learn about how these two problems are so connected?
I think what's most amazing in our own country is that the state of Mississippi both has the highest rate of obesity and the highest rate of hunger in our nation, coexisting in the same place. There's still 49 million hungry Americans while we have two-thirds of our population overweight or obese. So these things are in our own, just in our own country, totally coexisting. And if you think about it and you draw out exactly kind of what both of them are based on, it's very difficult no matter where you live, whether you're a wealthy person in the middle of a big cosmopolitan city or you are a less wealthy person in a rural area, it is hard to access nutritious foods no matter where you are. Mm-hmm. Whether it's expensive, it's not available, or it's just plain hard. Mm-hmm. I think that's our fundamental crisis in the food system that causes both hunger and obesity at the same time.
Now, as a mom, I have a 4 and a 6-year-old. What can moms do, or anyone at the grocery store as they're shopping, to try to change the state of our plate? I mean, is there things we can do, and would you give us 3 tips?
Well, a part of my organization, a new part, is called Change Dinner. Mm-hmm. And really it's about, listen, every one of us can do something. Mm-hmm. I've been talking a lot about recently about the idea of, you know, occupy your kitchen. In terms of the occupied movement, if you want to do something to improve the state of the world, do something in the food that you buy. Mm-hmm. And the other thing I think is so important is that, yes, food is expensive if right now we buy the expensive food, but we have to think, what is a value meal? You know, it seems like in America today that the data suggests that people watch around 4 hours of television and then say, I just don't have enough time or energy or money left behind to cook.
Cooking has become a spectator sport, essentially.
Well, we love to watch cooking shows, but then we don't want to necessarily, you know, do our own cooking in our own home. And I think we have to really reevaluate what is our time and what is it best spent for and what is our money best spent for. And I think that also plays into the longer term view of, if more people demand fruits and vegetables, organic produce, higher quality things that are grown regionally and keep the money in their own local and regional economy, those economies will grow. That's the nature of supply and demand. And if we really want to believe in the capitalist system that we're raised in, we have to spend our money exactly how we want to see the system become in the future.
One thing I thought you said that was very interesting during your talk was this idea of change as being dogma, and as being dogma. And as a registered dietitian, people are always saying, well, it's individual choice. Can you repeat the stat you talked about at the grocery store where there's an illusion of choice, but how is it connected to these issues?
Absolutely. You know, the USDA is telling us today to make half of the food on our plate fruits and vegetables. Unfortunately, first of all, in the top 10 products that are grown and produced in America, only one of them is a fruit, and it's tomato, probably used for ketchup. The other interesting fact is that 75% of the products, when you enter the grocery store, 75% of the products contain either corn, soy, or wheat. So that's not choice. That's one in three.
Yes.
And so I really think we as consumers have to fight back for that dogma and say, if we really want choice, you better give us real choice. There are 8,500 possible food products that we could be eating. Fruits and vegetables, different, you know, I'm not talking about the 17,000 food-like products. I'm talking about actual grown-in-the-ground food that we could be eating, and we are not getting that kind of choice at the grocery store.
I love that. Re-evaluating what a value meal really should mean. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thanks.